And now, steak and kidney pies, I think you've worked out the pricings on this, and it's very much cheaper to make them yourself, isn't it?
Just over half, even using first quality ingredients. I've used half steak and half kidney, Judith, because kidney, English kidney, was 29 pence a pound. And at one of these supermarkets, and so I thought that was very reasonable.
And this looks a nice bit of skirt.
It's a very good first quality English beef. And you cook the filling before you make the actual pastry. So to begin with, you would fry it just as we did in the lasagna until it's nice and brown, and then you put the flour, the lard here, or dripping, and you just enough to cook it in, and then add a heaped tablespoonful of flour to that, continue browning, and then once it's brown, add stock, half a pint if you've got it, if not, half a pint of water and a stock cube. And then it's flavoured with the chopped one onion.
And
simmer it until
it's
tender.
Salt and pepper. And the pastry, which you've already made here, you actually cut out. You put a bit on the bottom and on the top because it's a pie.
Well, it makes it much more economical if you do that, and it goes further. And after all, we're trying to do it like the bought ones, and therefore, I'll drop the, can you pick that up for me, Julie? It's the cutter outer. A bit short of space. There we are. I've already rolled out the bottoms of the pastry. This is just for the tops. And if you're doing these, the 12 ounces of pastry will make three 7-inch ones.
Like this size in the front here.
That's right. Or six of these smaller ones.
Right.
There we are. And then cut them out. This is just the size of the top of the flan. Here we are. That's, it just fits nicely. And so I've already got the ones made. Let's roll that back because I won't be rolling those out. Six of them, and the filling of a pound of meat just fills them. Now this is all right. And I've got the filling here. Now I haven't coloured it dark brown because I think it's rather nicer when it isn't. So I'll just do one to show you. Divide that between the six or three larger ones.
When you actually freeze those, Mary, what do you do? Do you just cover them with sort of foil or something?
That's right, yes. Then just put the, damp the edge around the outside. And you may not have a cutter for the bottom part. I used a tin
For the top part.
For the underneath, because that was deeper. Then put the lid on. There we are. Press it down all the way around. And then mark it with a fork. Press your finger underneath, then you get a really good seal.